friends. I hope you are having a great day. So, welcome to Creative Arts this week. We are going to be learning about a new instrument, and I have a video of the World Drum Club, Kalani, showing us how to use some instruments that use seed pods. This is a nyut, or they would call it a seed rattle or seed instrument. He has a really cool demonstration that's going to show you how they use it and different ways that they would take seed pods and create music with them. It's pretty cool. You can turn it, he'll show you, or shake it. Pretty cool, right? So, after we learn about the instrument, I have a special video of Cuckoo Kangaroo doing a little popsico. You know how that goes? My hands are high, my hands are low, and this is how we popsico, right? It's going to be a listening direction song for you to listen along to hear what you are supposed to do next. And then we are going to start on a new unit for the month of December, learning all about pine trees, evergreen trees. We see a lot of them out right now. I actually have some in my backyard and they have some pretty snow on it, which is really cool. And all you're gonna need for that is a white piece of paper, a blue sheet of paper, some scissors or pre-cut triangles out of green paper. We need some green paper, we need some glue sticks, and if you want, if you have white chalk, white paint, or white crayon, you can add snow to yours, but it's not necessary. So let's stick with our first thing, which is going to be learning all about the seed pod instruments, and then we'll get on to the rest of the stuff. Ready? Here we go.
Now, let's get to some really fun stuff. These are some seed pods. So, you know, in my book, all about hand percussion, I just call these the big seed pod rattle. It's kind of a belt. It's got a tie here, so this could be tied around your waist or maybe up here, I don't know. But they're awesome sounding. To me, this sound reminds me of, in some cases, you know, the sound of the waves coming up, and then when the waves go down, sometimes they'll move little rocks and shells and things. And that's kind of what this reminds me of. And then I have different sizes of these. These are the biggest ones. These are pretty big. There's some that are a little smaller. I think this is an awesome sound, beautiful sound effect. Okay, and then similar thing but smaller. And sometimes I'll wad these up and then clip them up on a stand so I can reach over with one hand. But these are ankle bracelets. These are made to be worn by dancers usually, but I just tied a few together. I use these on some of the shows. I used to take these on tour with Yanni, and I'd use these for anything that where we wanted maybe so like a rain stick. These can substitute for a rain stick, and it gets better. Super tiny. Isn't that the best sound? It's so delicate. Put some reverb on that and it's awesome. And then moving backwards, a little bit different style rattle. I have these, which are, you know, in the same family, I'm assuming, but bigger. So you have the rattle style, hand handheld style, and then the belt. And then, let's see, what else? I think I have one more thing in here, and that's just this little guy. Another kind of Andean, you know, pre-Columbian Native American instrument. Rattle. But what I would probably do with this is just make it a continuous sound like this. Just as a background sound. So yeah, thanks for dropping in, you guys. I appreciate you being World Drum Club supporters.
Hey Neil!
Hey what?
Are you ready?
For what?
To pop!
Pop what?
Popsico!
My hands are high, my feet are low, and this is how I popsico.
His hands are high, his feet are low, and this is how he popsicos.
Popsico, pop, popsico, popsico, pop, popsico.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
For what?
To pop.
Pop what?
Popsico.
My hands are high, my feet are low, and this is how I popsico.
His hands are high, his feet are low, and this is how he popsicos.
Pop. Sicko, pop, pop, sicko, pop, sicko, pop, pop, sicko.
Hey, Jeb.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
For what?
To pop.
Pop what?
Popsicko.
My hands are high, my feet are low, and this is how I popsicko.
His hands are high, his feet are low, and this is how he popsicles.
Pop, sicko, pop, pop, sicko, pop, sicko, pop, pop, sicko.
Hey, Clarence.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
For what?
To pop.
Pop what?
Popsico.
My hands are high, my feet are low, and this is how I popsico.
His hands are high, his feet are low, and this is how he popsicos. Popsico, pop, popsico, popsico, pop, popsico.
Hey, hot dog.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
For what?
To pop.
Pop what?
Popsico.
Okay, so you're going to need a white sheet of paper, a blue sheet of paper, some green paper, scissors, and a glue stick. All right, the first thing we're going to do is cut our blue sheet of paper in half. Then I'm going to take my green paper and I am going to fold it in half and I'm going to make triangles for the trees. So when I fold it in half, it makes two triangles. So those are two trees. And then I'm going to make a little smaller of a triangle because I want my trees to be different sizes. Now, because I used the folded half, I have to cut this one in half right on the line to make two. And then I'm going to make a taller but skinnier triangle as well for the largest one in our picture. If you want to make more, you can make more triangles. If you want to make less, you can do that as well. So there's our triangle shape, and those are going to be our trees. We're going to set them aside. We're going to grab our glue stick, and we are going to glue down the blue sheet of paper to the top of our white paper because that is going to be our sky. We've got blue skies ahead of us. And then I'm going to start to glue on
our triangles or our trees. You can place them in any order that you want. If you can see, the triangles are going to go onto the blue and onto the white. I'm going to overlap my trees, so they're going to go over the top of each other. And we're going to just glue them down. And I'm going to keep doing this with all of my triangles to create kind of a forest or woods in my picture. And you might have to go back and, like I did, and have to fix some of the little tiny spots that are coming up, and you can glue those. And then I had a white crayon. If you have a white crayon or you have chalk, you can add snow to your trees and to your sky if you'd like. I decided, because I saw, and I still can actually see, that there's some snow on some of the pine trees out in my backyard, I'm going to add some snow to this picture as well. And there you have it. Great job, guys. I hope you had fun. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to play this video again. So if you need to watch it again to do it, or if you missed a part, you'll be able to watch it one more time.
Have a great day, guys, and I'll see you next time.